नमस्कार, माय नेम इज हरदविंदर। एज यू नो फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर वी आर डेवलपिंग आवर ओन ईआरपी सिस्टम विद योर ग्रेट सपोर्ट। वी आर एडिंग वन मोर फैदर इन आवर कैप ऑफ सक्सेस। वी हैव डेवलप्ड एन ऑनलाइन क्विज मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम मीन्स फॉर कंडक्टिंग ऑनलाइन क्विज एमसीक्यूज। वी हैव डेवलप्ड we were already using Google Form, Testmos, Quizery and many more applications to do online quiz, but these applications have some limitations, as any outsider could try the quiz, can attempt the quiz by entering a fake name. We are not preventing the students with the security key if we are using these Google Form or Testmos like these. We did not limit it to school only, and it is difficult for us to manage the school record. For overcoming these limitations, we have developed the system across all these boundaries. I am going to give you a step-by-step guide on how you can use it. Please go through and tell us how we can improve it further. Well, first thing, you have to log in like this, teacher timetable management, then enter. Then you have to click here online quiz management. After clicking this, you see two options. One is create quiz and the second is manage schedule quiz. If you are creating a quiz for a new class, then you will click here create quiz. If you have already scheduled quiz and you want to result the school have already attempted, then you go to the option manage scheduled quiz. So firstly, I am going to create a new quiz for my class, and you will click here. After clicking here, you will select your name from drop-down menu, and then you will enter your security key. Ready? Open this page. I'm just opening. After that, these options you will see. Firstly, you will have to select the classes for which you are going to create a quiz. Suppose I am going to create a quiz for more than one class, so I don't need to create quiz again individually for the different classes. A single quiz I can create and it can be used for multiple classes very easily. Means the students of both the classes, the quiz will flash. They will enter through their security key. Suppose I am going to arrange a quiz for 9th division and 10th division both. So I will not create a quiz individually for both the classes. For combined collectively, I can create. Then I'll select the classes for which I am going to create a quiz. And then you will select your subject. My subject suppose for these classes information technology. And then you will schedule the date for which date you want to conduct the quiz. Suppose it will be on 18th of October. I want it should start at 3 o'clock evening and it should end up at the 7 o'clock evening. It means during these times students can attempt before or after they are able to do the quiz. We don't need to separately send, we don't need to send the link separately through WhatsApp group. Automatically on student login it will flash. Means your quiz have been scheduled by your teacher on October 18, 2021, and it will open at 3 o'clock evening and will close automatically at 7 o'clock. And automatically 3 o'clock it will open. You don't need to worry about. You just need to schedule once, and it will automatically open according to your as you have set up limits. Then you have to enter the topic name. Suppose my topic name is communications. I want to schedule. Suppose I want to schedule for two questions only. Now for this demonstration, I am entering only two. If I select 10 or 12, the video will be longer. So that's why I am just selecting two questions for. You can, and there's no limit. The maximum 100 questions 100 or 50 are informed in the message. One limit we have given, more than 50, I know, but exactly I forgot what is the limit. I'll second will write in the message. Then you will create a quiz, click here. Then you will see this page, and here you will add the questions. If you see this small box, then you can increase like this, no problem. So my first question, I don't need to write the numbering. Numbering will automatically flash over there. For the options also, we don't need to mention A, B, C. These will automatically flash to students. We just write the question. Numbering is already written. So I write it varies significantly completely. Means suppose I have said this question, it varies significantly from place to place, village to small towns to big cities. Then I'll add the options. The first option is facial expression, and the suppose the second is eye contact, and the third is none of the above. Both of these. The second question, suppose the second question is a message should not be sent if. You see, you can increase the size of your this box. Then you need to write the options like it is negative, channel is not suitable, it is complex, none of these. After that, you'll have to set the secure answer keys. If you want that this paper should automatically be checked, automatically be marked, then you have to set the answer keys. If you want to check it manually, then it's not required. But if you, I suppose it is better for you if you will set the answer key before that. You can save your time. It will be difficult for you to check the answer keys of 80-40 students for two classes. More than 80 students are there, so it's better it should automatically be checked. So then I can set the answer keys. I have already mentioned here we have include questions and their options, and select the correct option to be set up the answer key. Suppose it's first, its answer is second, and just I'm setting up the answer key. You have to select the correct answers here. And this is this. Then just you need to click here, click to update. Your quiz has been scheduled, and it will automatically flash on the student's login at the particular timings, which for 9th and 10th division, both classes, it will flash on their screen, and on that particular timing it will open for attempting, and during that time the students can attempt it, and after attemptation I can see the result directly. I don't need to check the answers manually because the answer key we have already set up. So this is a simple process. How can you schedule your test? Suppose you want to edit some, you want to edit the timing, date, or some questions you want to edit. Suppose you want to update the answer key. By mistake, you have mentioned the wrong answer key, then you can update. So for this purpose, again, you have to log in this timetable management system, then online quiz management, and here the second option is manage scheduled quiz if you want to add it. So here, and then again you will have to select your name and then your security key. I'm not entering the security key because I'm sharing the screen, so I have not set up right now. Then you will click. These are the tests which I have already scheduled, and right now I have scheduled for the 18th October, 9th Diligent and 10th Diligent, a communication skill 2. So these two tests I have just scheduled. So I can edit if I want. For editing, you'll have to go for separate classes. While creating for 9th and 10th, I have created only once. But if some changes I want to do, then I'll have to do separately. For 9th Diligent separately and 10th Diligent separately. So keep in mind, while creating the quiz, you can save your time for multiple classes, same quiz you can create. But if some mistakes or some editing you want to do, you'll have to go in all classes separately. Suppose in 9 trillion I want to edit, I want that 9 trillion students should attempt this quiz after 4 o'clock evening. Means or some questions also, if I want to edit, we can. I'll click here. Then I select the date. If I want to reschedule the date, I can 17. And then timing, I can update if I want. And any question, if I want to change, I can. Or I want to update the answer key, then also I can. And then just click, it has been updated. And then again, you just see I refresh it. And you see this timing is 4 o'clock now. And the date also I have updated, that is a 17th of October, earlier it was on 18th of October. So similarly, if you want to delete by mistake you have scheduled, or you want that should not flash on students login, then you can delete also. We have applied their delete button also. And after temptation, you can just click here, view result. You will see the complete result, which student has updated, means attempted the questions, and which are pending also. If you, we are conducting through Google form or this test modes, we were getting the list who's have attempted, but who's have not attempted, that will have to verify from other lists, from class list or somewhere. But here you will see the complete result, which student has attempted and which is in pending, and their score also in a serial order in a roll number wise. Means that we have restricted the students with their security key also. Means outsiders can't enter and can't attempt. If any student who is the part of that class of that school and they have the security key, their own personal, only those students can attempt this quiz. So we have limited it to the school only. So thank you. If you think that any updations or any suggestions, you can give us. Your suggestions are most valuable for us. So thank you. I hope you have understood and you will use it and give your valuable feedback. So thank you. Thank you very much.